Welcome to Supreme Success Online Tutorials. Today I will be teaching you on the topic motion. Motion. That's the movement of an object or a body from one place to the other. We have different types of motion. We have the linear motion, we have the projectile motion, we have circular motion, we have random motion, we have simple harmonic motion. So all these motions are what we are going to be looking at, the calculations involved in them. But before we go ahead into this topic, I would like to let you know that in physics, how do examiners frame their physics question? Number one, you can be asked to define, I call it definition of terms. You can ask to describe a concept, describe, or I call it description of concepts. Or they can ask you to describe an experiment, description of experiment. And you can be asked to derive, derivation of formulas. And lastly, you can be asked to do calculations. So these are different ways physics examiners gives you questions. So we are going to be looking each of these topics using this lens. What are the terms you are expected to be able to define? What are the concepts you are expected to be able to explain in that topic? Then is there any experiment in that topic? How do you describe the experiment in an examination situation? Then derivations of formula. How do we come about these various formulas? And lastly, calculations. This is the aspect that makes physics look difficult to many students. So don't worry, I'm going to be handling this extensively, and I need to promise you that I'll be concentrating majorly on calculations. But there's no way we do calculations without giving you some theoretical explanations before we go ahead. So in solving physics calculation, how do you approach physics calculation? I have this what I call 5R principle of solving problem. And what are the principles that are used to solve physics problems specifically and even life problems generally? Number one, read it. Some students in an examination, once they see a question, they see the question is like 5 lines, 6 lines, the question becomes, so they think because of the volume of the question is going to be difficult. Most of the times, those questions that are voluminous are always cheap. So don't run away from them, read it. Don't just look at the question, yeah, it resembles what you have done before, you just go ahead and pick the answer. No, just and or can change the nature of the question. So it is very important you read your question. The next thing you need to do to solve any problem is to reason it. Don't just read the question, reason it. What do I mean by reason? You think about the question. What are they trying to say? What are they trying to ask me to find? What are they giving informations? How could I go ahead and solve it? So you need what? To reason it. Then the next thing that you need to do to solve a problem is to record it. Don't just reason it without recording it. I always teach my students, right, given that, then you are given velocity equals to 2.5 meters per second, you write the given informations out. Then number one, you record it. At times you can use diagram to illustrate the question, to give you a kind of mental picture on how to go about solving the question. Then number four is to relate it. There is nothing that is not related. You are looking at me, I don't know you, you don't know me, but there is a way we are related together. Everything has connection. Everything there is has relation. So in physics, we have different formulas that relate different given parameters together. So you need to think of the right formula. At times, it might not just be one formula. It might be two or three formula that one will lead to another one, that you have to find A to find B in such a way that will help you to find C. So you must be able to what? To relate it together. And if you have been able to relate the given parameters together, the next thing you have is what? You have your results. You result it. So these are my five R principle of solving problems. Not just physics problem, I apply it to life problems also. So let's go back to what we want to do today. We are going to motion. So linear motion is what we are touching today. Linear motion, this is the motion of an object in a straight line. And when we say straight line, it can either be a horizontal motion, or it's a vertical motion. Like you throw an object up, or an object falls to down vertically. So linear motion is the motion of an object in a straight line. And there are terms you need to familiarize yourself with. You need to know them. Number one, you need to know what is distance. Distance, we use S to represent it, is measured in meter. You need to know displacement. What is different between displacement and distance? Distance is a scalar quantity, while displacement is a vector quantity. That is, displacement is distance in a given direction. Please don't mind my speed. You need to just brace up your mind and follow me. Speed, you need to know what speed is. Velocity, you need to be able to define velocity. You will see all this in your textbook. Then you need to know we have different types of velocity. We have initial velocity. We use U to represent it. We have final velocity. We use V to represent it. We have our correlative velocity. We use VR to represent it. We have what we call instantaneous velocity. You need to know this term. They are very important because these are terms you will be coming across in your question. Then we have acceleration. We use small letter A to represent acceleration. You have deceleration. We use also A to represent it, but it's negative. So these terms, you need to know them, know their SI units, know the symbols we use to represent them, and you must be able to define them. You will see them in your textbooks. Then, now that we've gotten this, the next thing you need to know is what we call equation of linear motion. These are laws that governs everything that happens in linear motion. We have three of them. The first one is V equals to U plus AT. The second one is, we said S equals to UT plus half AT squared. Then the third one is V squared equals U squared plus 2AS. You need to know these three formulas. You need to know what varies among them, and you need to be able to apply them. For you to apply these three equations to solve any physics problem, you have to have these PowerPoints that I'm about to give you. You have to have them at the front of your mind. Mind at the front of your mind, not at the back of your mind. The first one, when objects starts from rest, what does that tell us? It tells us that your u, initial velocity, is zero. Number two, when object goes to rest, you need to know that V, final velocity, is zero. So when you are reading the question, you come across this information there. You should know what they mean. Then number three, when object moves against gravity. That is, you throw an object up, acceleration equals to minus 9.81 meters per second squared. Then number four, when object moves or when objects fall down, falls under gravity. Under gravity, we have our A equals to what? 9.81, that's plus meters per second squared. And lastly, when you hear that object moves with a uniform, when they say uniform, constant, uniform or constant, which other times do we use steady or steady velocity? When you hear that in your question, you must know that acceleration is zero. So if you have all this information at the front of your mind, you are going to be able to solve any question on linear motion. So let me try and solve maybe one question for you on an horizontal motion, then I treat one question with you on vertical motion. Yeah, let me bring this question up. There's this question why I asked 1 year like that. I think 2007. The question says a body accelerates from rest. Please, you won't mind my abbreviations so as to save my time. At 2 meters per second, 2 meters per second square, calculate the magnitude. Calculate the magnitude of the velocity with which it is traveling. Now, how do you solve this question? Don't forget, I said read the question. We have read the question. The next thing you need to do is what? Reason the question. Think, what are they trying to say? A body accelerates from rest. You remember I told you when object starts from rest, just write, given that your u equals to zero, it now accelerates as it accelerates, that's acceleration. So this goes to this as 2 meters per second squared. Then the question is asking that with what? You're about to stop. Let's take this question. A body accelerates from rest. With 2 meters per second squared, calculate its velocity. If it travels a distance of 9 meters. So how do you solve this question? Solution. Right, giving information or giving that, what are those things given to you? We have read the question, the less reasoning. A body accelerates from rest, that means your u equals to zero according to PowerPoint 1, with acceleration, that's 2 meters per second square. Once you see the unit here, the unit will reveal the given parameters to you, that's 2 meters per second square. Calculates its velocity. That's what we are looking for. If it travels a distance. Distance, I've told you to use S to represent your distance of 9 meters. So, how do we go about solving this question? Which equation do you think we can use to address this situation? Equation 1 has time. We cannot use that. Equation 2 also has time. We cannot use that. But equation 3 is the perfect equation that we can use to relate this given information. We have read it, we have reasoned it, we have recorded it, then we are relating it. So using v square equals to u square plus 2ax. So your v, your u is 0, 2 times a is also 2, your distance is 9. You just substitute the given information. V square equals to 4 times 2 times 2, 4. 4 times 9, that's 36. So your V equals to square root of 36. Your answer is 6 meters per second. Don't forget, I told you that unit is very important. don't calculate something without putting the appropriate unit there. Put the appropriate unit there. So this is a question on horizontal motion. Let's take another question on a vertical motion. A question on a vertical motion. Let's take a question on a vertical motion that, let's say for instance, an orange draws. So let's take this question. An orange draws from a height of 45 meters. Draws from a height of 45 meters tall to 45 meters tall to the ground. How long does it take to reach the ground? So this is a question of vertical motion. Then you ask yourself, is it against gravity or under gravity? So one, your solution, don't forget, don't just go ahead and solve question. Given that, read the question, write down the given information. If you don't write down the given information given to you, it's just as if you are fighting someone without getting close to the person you want to fight. When you write the given information down in a numerical way, you understand me? You are taking many steps closer to the question you are trying to solve. So you can give your question punches like you like. So it's very important you write this given information down. You have an orange draws from a tree. Let's say this is a tree. It drops to the ground. The height of the tree is 45 meters. That's your distance. This is your tree. So 45 meters is the height. It drops to the ground. The question says you must know that before dropping, initial velocity will be zero. Your distance is 45 meters. And we are looking for T. But if you look at it, they didn't say anything about A. The question says something about A. When object falls down under gravity, your acceleration equals to 9.8. But let's just use 10 meters per second squared and approximate it. So they won't give you the question, but you must take your, it takes your reasoning to get that. So we use which of the equation, that second equation, S equals to UT plus half AT squared. So your S is 45, your U is 0, your T times half, your A is 10, and your T is what we are looking for. So you have 45 equals 0. Okay, let's let that this cancels this. You have 5 T squared. 5 divides both sides. You have 9 equals to T squared. Therefore, your T equals to 3. That's square root of 9. No, let me jump that. That's 3 meters. 3 seconds. That is the answer to the question. So I'm going to pose some questions for you to solve. Just solve them. If you have any problem, you can ask your question in the comment section below this video. See you in the next class.